Ông quý chủ. Ông chủ nội dung đẹp và cả mình to cái trong là cả nội tế vị trí xã Mạc Cà. Một nông đo là vị trí cả chủ từ rộng mệt vị cả biết cái đấy. Ông chủ đẹp xung chủ đẹp chủ nông đăng đo vị kỳ đang ở nơi rừng cái đấy nít thà nơi không cái trong là cả xã Mạc Cà nơi rừng này. Đại lục cho cầm dụ tà rá đại chế cho cầm khiết អវត្តមានដែលមូលហេតុគាត់មានធុរៈចាំបាច់ផ្ទាល់ខ្លួនគាត់មិនអាចចូលរួមក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសហគមន៍នេះបានបន្ទាប់ពីយើងខ្ញុំវិភាក្សាពីគ្រូយោបល់ជាមួយនឹងបណ្ដាចក្រមពេញសិទ្ធិនៃអង្គជំរះសាលាដំបងយើងសម្រេចតែងតាំងលោកចក្រមធូមនីដែលជាចក្រមបំរុងភិក្ខុជាតិជំនួសកន្លែងចក្រមយុវតារាដែលបានអវត្តមាននៅរុស្ស៊ីនេះហើយការសម្រេចនេះផ្អែកលើបទបញ្ញត្តិនៃវិធានចាត់ទៅ9 4នៃវិធានផ្ទៃក្នុង
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Your Honours, Council. Good afternoon, Mr. Witness. I have a few more questions that I would like to put to you. Before the lunch break, we were speaking about this special unit of lazy people, as you call it. I believe you also gave testimony earlier that you thought that the majority of the people who were working in that unit were base people. Is that indeed your testimony? And can you tell us why you knew or how you come to know that they were majority base people in that special unit?
ตามการสังเกตของខ្ញុំให้ធ្លាប់នៅក្នុងកងជាមួយគ្នាយើងដឹងពីដូចខ្ញុំនិយាយទៅដែរគឺសម្លៀកបំពាក់តួខ្លួនយើងអាចដឹងថាអ្នក17ឬក៏អ្នកមូលដ្ឋាន
So it's on the basis of the clothes that the people in that special unit were wearing that you are saying that the majority in that special unit for lazy people consisted of base people. Is that correct?
God man.
Do you remember the name of the chief of this unit, the special unit of lazy people? Do you remember or do you know to whom he himself had to report who his superior was? Okay, thank you. Now let me get back to a question about the approximately 97% of the workers who were apparently not to be considered lazy,
working at the dam.
We listened to the audio recording of your interview, and we heard that you say at one particular time that if your group had finished the work or not, you could continue the work the next day, and that you were not forced, and that you only were forced to work hard and nothing else. Is that something that you said, you remember saying to the investigators?
Bạn đôi chị chăm bạn là về nước nhầm gì chẳng mềm.
And we also heard you say that as long as the workers in your group was not lazy, were not lazy, then there would not be any problem for them and for you. Is that correct as well?
Because
as long as you're not lazy, no problem? So is it then fair to conclude that 97% of the workers at the dam site that you were working with in your unit had no problem? Now one or two questions, Mr. Witness, about working times. There is a witness and one or two seem to have confirmed this, that lunch, the lunch break was between either 11 and 2 o'clock or 11 and 1 o'clock.
Is that
a correct observation of
these witnesses?
Some other witnesses who have testified before the trial chamber last week have also told us that there was a break in the morning session, a break of about 15 minutes right in the middle of the morning session, in the session before lunch. Is that correct as well? Some witnesses have also given testimony about working at night. One has said that working at night was occasional, only sometimes, and one also said that it was only working at night when the moon was waxing, so about once a month. Is that your recollection as well? Your recollection about the times working at night?
And
can you explain us when there would be a special case, under what circumstances would there be a special situation that would make the workers work at night?
Uh,
ករណីពិសេសនាំឲ្យពលករនឹងធ្វើការនៅពេលយប់យើងមិនអាចដឹងថាករណីនឹងបែបណាទេ
Thank you. Do you remember seeing heavy equipment at the dam site, such as bulldozers shoving away soil?
Lan chu day nó cứ thả chu với chu chai day nấu cà rán nấu đại thế.
Mình thlop khơi tae đạch 79 khnyom ban khơi krueng chak neu knong prei tanop 6 mekara mien bol mien krueng chak masin de set e no
and where these In your memory, the bulldozers and heavy equipment that had been left there by
bulldozer and upakor thun thungun
the authorities in the DK regime.
That took shawl nuti nu doy anya tho Cambodia pichet thup tai rư ko ot de.
Doy anya tho Cambodia pichet thup tai tuk chawl rot chawl dai 79 nung tae. Vi tuk chawl.
And in your recollection, do you know what kind of heavy equipment it was that you saw? Were they bulldozers, etc.? What kind of machinery did you see?
ឈូកខ្នល់មានប៉ែលពីក្រោមហើយនឹងរោងជាងដែកជាងអីនៅកន្លែងគ្រឹះចាក់នោ
ះ during the time that you worked at the first January dam work site, did you ever see soil collapse and soil subsequently burying workers, or did you never see that?
Mình đã khơi thì bên tay thọp lư nơi cái lại xe những cái thà đây bạn đó xưa tới thà cái lại thưa sầm nong thôm chị đã cứ chơi về tới cứ bạn chúng ta slap rồi có rô phẩm man như nhưng mình đừng
Did you, while you worked there, also experience the use of explosives to soften up the rocky bottom? Returning again to the food situation in
the unit that worked at the dam.
Do you know who was responsible for bringing the food at the dam site where you worked? Who was responsible for the food logistics?
ແລະຫນ້າຕຕួលຄົບຖ້າຄາງພ្នែកພໍພຽກາງພ្នែកດັກຈັນຈູນອາຈໍາໃນອາຫານຍົກມາឲ្យປົນລະກອນໃນອາຍຕົມນຸກນັ້ນເລື່ອງຫມໍບເລື່ອງຊີວະພຽບປະບໍອີ່ໃດນັ້ນຄືເຈິງດ້າຫມໍບໃນກະໃນກະໄລໂຮງໄວ້ມັນມີປີນາດັກນ້ອມຍົກຕໍ່ឲ្យດໍກະໄລທີ່ພູໂຮງເຈິງໃນ
I understand, but do you know who brought the food to the dining hall where everybody was eating? How did the food get there, and who was responsible for bringing that food in the dining hall?
I
apologize, maybe my question is not very clear. I'm trying to find out how the food that you ate had gotten there, who had brought it to the place. Where did the food come
from?
ហើយនឹងមានអង្គមានអីចង្រុកគេសម្រាប់ឲ្យចុងភៅវរៈគ្រប់វរៈព្រលឹមឡើងលបប្រមាណនឹងគេនឹងវល់ឲ្យមកតាមវរៈរៀងៗខ្លួនហ្នឹងលើសេដ្ឋកិច្ចវរៈទេអ្នកទៅយកផ្ទាល់ត្រូវបានប្រមាណគេបបោប្រមាណយើង
This logistics chief, was he coming from the sector or was he coming from a district?
មកពីថ្នាក់ស្រុកឬក៏មកពីថ្នាក់តំបន់
មេសេដ្ឋកិច្ចនៅបើតាមខ្ញុំឮឈ្មោះគឺនៅភូមិជិតគ្នានឹងខ្ញុំដែរតែគាត់អ្នកតស៊ូអញ្ចឹងទៅគាត់បានកាន់ប្រធានសេដ្ឋកិច្ចជាស្រីទេគេហៅយាយណៃ
So this female cadre was responsible for the 500 or 600 people that were working together. Is that correct?
គាត់ក្តាប់សេដ្ឋកិច្ចរួមមកសង្កាត់នឹងមានវរៈបុរសវរៈនារីវរៈយុវជន បីវរៈហ្នឹងខ្ញុំមិនដឹងថាស្ថិតិទេប្រមាណទេប៉ុន្តែបើវរៈយុវជនវរៈទី2ខាងដែលខ្ញុំនៅគឺពី 5 ទៅ 600 នាក់
Is this female cadre that you just mentioned still alive today? This morning, you spoke briefly about a militiaman named Lun. I believe you also said this morning that you rarely saw him at the dam. He himself gave testimony to investigators and he said that he had never been at the dam.
Have
you
tried
to recollect if you
ចូលមកជាយាមនឹកឡើងវិញមើលថាតើលោកធ្លាប់ដែលបានឃើញគាត់នៅឯកាលឋានលើកទំនប់ទេដោយខ្ញុំនិយាយពីព្រឹកថាគាត់ច្រើននៅធ្វើការនឹងតាមភូមិទាំងប្រមាណហ្នឹងច្រើនត្រង់ថាទៅការដ្ឋានមួយមករានឹង ដូចជាមិនគាត់មិនសូវឃើញមកដាក់ម្ដងហ្នឹងដូចជាគាត់មានកាយផងយើងអត់ដឹង
Do you remember? Yes. Do you remember where you saw him? Under which circumstances? Did he just pass by? Can you give us a little more detail?
Thank you, Mr. President. I just want to correct what I think is an inaccurate characterization of the statement that Lun gave. There is a point in his statement at which he says that he was never sent to guard the first January dam. But he also says that he saw Kai Pok come to inspect the first January dam and that he was tasked with carrying earth at that construction site for 3 months. So the statement is not that he was never there. The statement is that he was there for 3 months. Yes, I think he seems to limit it to guard. But the point was more, Mr. President, to ask the witness when he says rarely what that means. So it was once that you saw him. What else do you remember of this one occasion?
Thank you, Mr. Witness.
Moving on to a next subject, this morning you said that you overheard people say something about two or three workers being taken away and thrown in a well and killed. Do you know the names of the people that you overheard?
មនុស្សដែលបាននិយាយអំពីរឿងសម្លាប់នេះដែរទេ
នៅចាំគឺគាត់ជាប្រធានវរៈយុវជននៅរស់សពថ្ងៃ
Do you know how they knew about the fate of these workers? Have they seen it themselves, or have they in their turn subsequently heard it as well? Do you know the source of their apparent knowledge of the fate of these people?
តើលោកដឹងថាអ្នកដែលនិយាយនេះគាត់ដឹងប្រភពនៃការសម្លាប់នេះមកពីណាដែរទេ
ខ្ញុំមិនដឹងទេគាត់តែបានឮ
Do you remember
maybe we
realized a long time ago but do you
លោកចាំទេ
ខ្ញុំដឹង
ថារយៈពេលវាយូរយារណាស់មកហើយលោកនៅចាំពាក្យពេចន៍ពិតប្រកបដែលអ្នកទាំងនោះនិយាយទេ
គេគាត់ថាអឺទុកក៏មិនចំណេញដកចេញចោលវាដកចេញក៏វាមិនខាតដែរគឺគេប្រើពាក្យនឹងថាសុខចិត្តវាយច្រឡំកុំឲ្យទុកច្រឡំ
I understand, but that sounds very general. Did you hear them say anything specific about these two or three workers?
Details as to
which well, what time, any specific details?
សពទាំង3នៅទៅក្នុងអណ្ដូងគឺចំណុចលម្អិតបែបនេះលោកនៅចាំទេ
មិនចាំទេគាត់ថាពេលដែលឮនោះសំសួរម្ដងទៀត
My question is about
any
detail you might remember
about this conversation that you said you overheard.
Did they say which well these two workers were thrown in, by whom, what time, why?
ហេតុអ្វីបានជាគេសម្លាប់អ្នកទាំង3ហ្នឹងហើយគេទម្លាក់ទៅក្នុងអណ្ដូងថាលោកចាំចំណុចជាក់លាក់ទាំងនេះខ្លះខ្លះដែរទេ
យើងខ្ញុំមិនចាំទេដល់អត់ចាំសំដីអស់ទាំងហ្នឹងទេគាត់ថាឮថាយប់មិញទម្លាក់អណ្ដូងទី3ហ្នឹងថាទម្លាក់ឯណានោះយើងមិនដឹងភ័យតែខ្លួនឯងផង
I'll move on to my last questions.
May the week you have a daughter to sue some of your brother, Mahyam.
You spoke briefly this morning about the visit of a Chinese delegation. Do you know anything more specific? Do you know any names of Chinese leaders that came visiting the first January
day?
Mình bàn chăm thế, tầm mục mình bàn khơi như thế. Còn tại đằng thà, cái nạn rò thì phu màu xung phốt. Thì thấy bài tức rệt đây rồi xa, xoa hạp lang. Mì con prap màn bình thường. Thế chiều tới có dương mình bàn khơi là chẳng ai nà. Thì chi chun chả ơn.
You were instructed to work harder when the delegation was visiting.
Were you also instructed to
put more soil in the baskets and to run with the soil rather than to walk?
And
did that also include putting some extra soil in the baskets that you were carrying? And It's maybe a little bit difficult question that I'm going to ask you, but would it be possible for you to make a distinction in the amount of soil in terms of kilos that you would put on a normal day on your basket and on your basket in those few hours that the foreign delegation came to visit? Would you be able to make such an estimate?
Ngày thòm nã đã phải phần màn cổ lỗ hay phê bọt phù tổ mơ lưng đã phải phần màn kỳ lỗ.
Kết cổ lỗ thòm thà thằng ngày thòm đã dự đã mà mà bất kỳ dân tới rứa có tách chiên mình đo bình bất kỳ dân tới đó ngày tùa nó cứ dân tới đã ở cặp phùng hay rè ở bàn lươn.
It's a long time ago, I understand, but are you able to estimate how many kilos of soil you would typically
carry?
The maximum.
I understand. My last question, Mr. Witness, do you know why the first January dam and the sixth January dam got their respective names?
Why the dam was called the first January dam, had a way, the 6th January dam, had a way,
Thank you very much, Mr. Witness. I'm looking at my national colleague. We're done. Thank you, Mr.
President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Monsieur Uth Seng. Je m'appelle Antagissé, je suis co-avocat international de Monsieur Kusanton et je vais vous poser quelques brèves questions pour avoir certaines précisions sur votre déposition. J'ai cru comprendre de votre déposition que au moment de l'inauguration du barrage du 1er janvier, vous aviez déjà commencé à travailler sur ce barrage. Est-ce que j'ai bien compris? Et j'ai compris aussi que vous avez travaillé pendant une durée peut-être un petit peu inférieure à 3 mois. Ma question est donc la suivante. Est-ce que, après avoir fini de travailler sur le barrage du 1er janvier, vous avez été amené à retourner sur les lieux en cours de travaux ou à la fin des travaux sur ce barrage?
J'avais
bien compris ce point. En fait, ma question, c'est de savoir si, après avoir fini de travailler sur ce barrage, vous êtes revenu sur ce barrage pour une raison ou pour une autre, notamment, par exemple, s'il y a eu une cérémonie à la fin, à l'issue des travaux sur ce barrage.
Vous avez indiqué que ce barrage était assez grand, qu'il,
avec les canaux, en tout cas, qu'il s'étendait sur plusieurs kilomètres. Est-ce qu'il est dans ces conditions exactes de dire que vous-même, quand vous avez travaillé sur ce barrage, vous n'étiez que sur un site particulier sur ce grand chantier et que vous n'avez pas visité les autres sites un peu plus éloignés de ce chantier?
Je vais peut-être poser ma question différemment parce qu'apparemment, je n'ai pas de réponse de votre part. Donc, ma question est de savoir si nous sommes bien d'accord que lorsque vous avez travaillé sur ce chantier du site du barrage du 1er janvier, vous n'avez travaillé que sur une partie de ce chantier, que vous n'avez pas visité toutes les parties sur les plusieurs dizaines de kilomètres que composait ce barrage.
Et pour rebondir sur ce que vous avez indiqué tout à l'heure à mon confrère, vous avez indiqué que vous, sur votre partie du chantier sur lequel vous avez travaillé, vous n'aviez pas vu de machine, mais vous avez indiqué que après la fuite du régime, vous en avez vu dans la forêt. Donc, ma question est la suivante, est-ce que nous sommes d'accord pour dire qu'il est possible que sur votre... partie du chantier des machines n'est pas utilisée, mais que n'est pas été utilisée, pardon, mais que sur d'autres parties du chantier, il y a pu avoir l'utilisation de machines sans que vous-même vous n'ayez pu les voir.
Dương mình đăng vô thà nơi chẳng ai bị khỉa dương thua ca ta mà đống thằng thà đạch tới chân bốn cứ khơi cái đường chạy miền bồ thông thông miền à đê xết đây chân từ lại cái đường chạy cái đường chiên rôn chiên là thông mùi bò ngày cả hòm
C'est précisément là où je veux en venir, monsieur le témoin, c'est que dans votre déclaration E3-5267, ERN en français 00482932, ERN en Khmer 00271407, ERN en anglais 00282354. Voilà ce qui a été noté dans votre déclaration. Ce barrage-là a été construit en terre uniquement et à la force humaine. Fin de citation. De ce que vous avez indiqué sur les machines que vous avez vues, sur aussi la remarque faite par monsieur le juge Lavergne sur le fait que au moins le mur du barrage avait été fait en ciment et avec des barres de fer, on est d'accord que lorsque vous dites ce barrage-là a été construit en terre uniquement et à la force humaine, vous, vous parlez de la partie sur laquelle vous avez travaillé.
តែប៉ុណ្ណឹងទេតើអញ្ចឹងមែនទេបើជាអញ្ចឹងមែនប៉ុន្តែគាត់តែយើងនៅធ្វើការអញ្ចឹងតែយើងលឺថាហ្នឹងអីនោះគេធ្វើសំណង់ធំប៉ុនយើងពុំមានសិទ្ធិដើរហើរទៅមើលទៅអីអត់មានទេប៉ុណ្ណឹង
Un autre point que je voudrais aborder avec vous, c'est les réunions que vous avez évoquées. Vous avez parlé de réunions en fin de journée après votre travail sur le barrage. Et je voudrais savoir si, au cours de l'une de ces réunions, votre chef d'unité ou quelqu'un d'autre aurait expliqué pourquoi ce barrage a été construit. Vous avez évoqué avec mon confrère tout à l'heure le fait que ce barrage avait été utile après 78 et jusqu'aux années 90. Donc ma question est de savoir si pendant ces réunions que vous aviez sur le chantier, on vous a expliqué l'intérêt de ce barrage ou pas.
បាននិយាយគឺនិយាយថាប្រឹងធ្វើការជាប្រចាំទៅបាន
Et vous qui avez assisté à l'inauguration de ce barrage. Est-ce que vous avez indiqué, pardon, que même si vous étiez loin, vous avez entendu certains discours, certaines présentations par haut-parleur? Est-ce que ce jour-là, on a expliqué l'intérêt de ce barrage ou est-ce que vous ne vous en souvenez pas? Il n'y a pas de souci, si vous ne vous en souvenez pas, je ne vais pas vous embêter plus avant. Je voudrais revenir sur votre déclaration devant les coaches d'instruction et sur un point que vous avez commencé à aborder avec mon confrère. Mais je voudrais plus précisément revisiter avec vous ce que vous avez exactement dit lors de votre entretien avec les enquêteurs, puisque nous avons la transcription officielle d'une partie de cette interview. Et je voudrais vous soumettre certains points en vous relisant vos déclarations et vous poser ensuite des questions. Il s'agit du document D166.82.1. ERN en français 01 10 1 6 5 6. ERN en Khmer 0 1 1 0 1 5 9 7. Et il n'y a pas de transcription en anglais, mais il s'agit donc de la transcription du document audio D166-82R. Et les passages qui m'intéressent se trouvent entre 1h33 et 25 secondes et 1h35 et 30 secondes. Vous avez abordé ce point encore une fois avec mon confrère, mais je voudrais vous soumettre exactement ce que vous avez indiqué ce jour-là. Voilà la question qui vous est posée à propos de l'organisation du travail au sein de votre groupe. La question de l'enquêteur M. Hoy est la suivante. Mais une fois répartis en sous-groupes, comment était attribué le quota de travail de chacun de leurs membres? Combien de mètres cubes de terre devait transporter chacun des groupes de 3 personnes? Votre réponse a été la suivante. Cela variait en fonction de la taille du canal en question. On estimait que chacun devait au moins creuser 1 mètre cube de terre par jour. L'enquêteur poursuit ses questions. Mais vous, personnellement, combien de mètres cubes de terre deviez-vous transporter par jour? Vous répondez par jour et l'enquêteur poursuit. Vous en souvenez-vous encore? Et là, votre réponse est la suivante. Chacun devait transporter 1 mètre de terre par jour sur la longueur du canal. Si nous n'arrivions pas à le faire, nous n'avions pas continué à travailler normalement. Or, il n'était pas utile de faire preuve d'hypocrisie au travail, puisqu'on ne nous faisait rien de mal. Comme nous ne pouvions pas finir le quota imposé, il fallait continuer le lendemain. Fin de citation. Ma première question par rapport à ce premier extrait est de savoir, déjà si vous vous souvenez bien avoir dit ça, et si vous confirmez que lorsque vous ne pouviez pas finir le quota, il fallait continuer le lendemain.
ខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់កាលដែលខ្ញុំនិយាយ1ម៉ែត្របណ្ដោយហ្នឹងគឺនិយាយក្នុងការឋានបលាយរបស់សង្កាត់ដែលមានទំហំតូចប្រមាណ 1 ម៉ែត្រឬក៏ខ្នង 5ម៉ែត្រអីចឹងគឺគេចែកជាក្រុមពី 3 នាក់ហ្នឹងមួយម៉ែត្រហ្នឹងទៅជម្រៅតាមស្ថានភាពដីជម្រៅបាតបលាយយើងជីកថា 1ម៉ែត្រវាកើតខ្នងបលាយជាស្រេច
Alors, ma question va être là plus précisément sur une autre partie pour savoir si on est bien d'accord. Plus loin sur ce même enregistrement, vous avez indiqué la chose suivante. Le quota de travail était par exemple organisé comme suit. Si un sous-groupe recevait un quota de 3 mètres de terre à transporter, il fallait donc que ces 3 membres s'y mettent ensemble. Question de l'enquêteur, tous les 3, et votre réponse, si on n'arrivait pas à finir, on pouvait continuer le lendemain sans contrainte, à moins qu'on ne fasse preuve de persévérance dans notre travail. Fin de citation. Ma question est la suivante, là encore, est-ce que vous parlez des canaux qui ne sont pas en lien avec le barrage du 1er janvier, ou est-ce que ces consignes-là, le fait de faire un travail de groupe et d'avoir un quota pour l'ensemble du groupe, correspond également à votre travail sur le barrage du 1er janvier?
ពីតំណប់មួយមករាកងក្នុងកងរបស់ខ្ញុំហ្នឹងគឺគេចែកជាក្រុម3ក្រុមទៀតធ្វើការជាសមូហភាពទូបីដូចថារួចមិនរួចគឺយើងប្រឹងធ្វើសកម្មភាពធម្មតាមិនបាច់សម្រុកទេមិនរួចគឺស្អែកគឺមានផែនការបន្តហើយតែយើងប្រឹង
Et est-il exact que pour vous, il était compliqué d'évaluer exactement quel était le mètre cube de quota attribué au groupe, affecté au groupe?
រួចក៏មិនបានទៅរោងឬក៏បានឈប់សម្រាកទេយើងធ្វើការតាមលទ្ធភាពដើម្បីដល់ម៉ោងល្ងាចទោះបីរួចមុនម៉ោងអោះក៏គ្មានសិទ្ធិអង្គុយប្រាច់ឬអត់ធ្វើអីទេអញ្ចឹងយើងសិក្សាទៅថាធ្វើឲ្យសកម្មឲ្យដល់ម៉ោងផងដែរ
J'ai bien compris cette partie de votre déposition, monsieur le témoin, mais ma question, elle est différente. J'ai compris que vous avez travaillé de votre mieux. Ma question est de savoir si vous étiez en mesure d'évaluer ce que ça voulait dire en mètres cubes. Vous contentiez de creuser, ça j'ai bien compris. Est-ce que vous êtes en mesure de dire quel était le volume en mètres cubes? Ou est-ce que vous n'êtes pas en mesure, et là il n'y a pas de problème, je passe à un autre point.
ពីវរៈអញ្ចឹងយើងចែកគេឲ្យប្រមាណប្រមាណម៉ែត្រអញ្ចឹងទៅយើងចែកគ្នាទៅមកកងហ្នឹងវាបានប្រមាណម៉ែត្រយើងកង់ជា3ក្រុមមកយើងធ្វើមិនដឹងជាថាគិតគិតភពអីគេថាកាលហ្នឹងយើងដឹងតែពីប្រឹងកាប់ធ្វើទៅម៉េចឲ្យថាពីថ្ងៃឲ្យរួចយើងឲ្យរួចពីថ្ងៃមកប៉ុណ្ណឹង
Je vous remercie, c'est exactement l'objet de ma question. Un dernier point que je voudrais aborder avec vous, vous avez évoqué un certain Lone avec Monsieur le coprocureur et tout à l'heure avec mon confrère. J'ai cru comprendre de votre déposition que vous avez indiqué que ce Lone serait mort il y a 3 ou 4 ans. C'est ce que j'ai noté dans mes notes. Est-ce que vous confirmez ce point ou est-ce qu'on a mal compris votre déposition?
ខ្ញុំដូចជាមិនបានថាគាត់ស្លាប់ទេប៉ុន្តែវាបាត់មុខគាត់តាំងពីគាត់ជាប់គុកចិត្ត9 ចេញពីចិត្ត9ជួបគាត់20ដាំងពីនឹងមក
Et pour rebondir sur une des questions posées par mon confrère tout à l'heure, est-ce que pendant la période où vous avez été sur le barrage, vous l'avez vu à un moment ou à un autre faire partie des unités qui creusaient les canaux sur le barrage du 1er janvier?